Links are a great way of connecting one web page to another web page, but they can also connect one part of a web page to another part of that same web page, especially on really long web pages, like for a table of contents. I've now added a bunch more information to this page so that I could give you a history of the web and a history of HTML versions, and I think it's enough content that it deserves a table of contents. And I've started one up here, just an unordered list, with list items which each of the section titles. And I want to link each of these section titles so you can click them and just go to that part of the page. To do that, I once again use the A tag. So I'll start by just wrapping this title in start and end tags for A. Now, what should go as the href of this link? Well, we need to somehow tell the browser where to jump to in the web page. Some way of uniquely identifying that part of the page. If you've learned CSS selectors already, you've actually seen how to do this, in fact. We can do it by adding an ID attribute to a tag. Let's scroll down and find the heading here. And we'll add an ID attribute to this heading. So I'm going to put my cursor in H2, type ID equals, and come up with a good identifier that's unique, like web-history. Okay, let's scroll back up to the link. And now, in order to tell the browser to go to this internal link, we need to start with a hash sign, and then type exactly the ID like we typed it below. Okay, so now, pause this talk through and try clicking the link. Go on, I will wait. Clicky, 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 clicky. Okay, did you see it scroll down to the section? Then it worked. We can add more links like that by putting ID attributes on every heading and making A tags that point at them, but I'll leave that for you to try. The big thing to remember is that the IDs must be unique because otherwise the browser won't know where to jump to. So make them nice and descriptive.